There is not a single doubt that we are living in a three-dimensional universe which works on the fourth-dimensional timeline, which is time. Hindu religion explains that this third-dimensional universe is a material universe which is just an illusion, or in Hinduism we call it Maya. Maya is nothing but dream of a god. According to Vedas, it is believed that our universe comes into being when Lord Vishnu falls asleep and Brahma emerges from his navel and begins the work of creation. Then, you can say that the avatars of Vishnu were his successful attempts to perform Inception on the minds of people. Now, if you have seen the movie Inception by Christopher Nolan, you might be familiar with some of the terms which we will use in this video. Lord Vishnu can be compared to Kab or any other dreamer. Ariadne can be compared to Brahma, who creates the world of dream, and Mal can be compared to our inner thoughts or our suicidal thoughts. The dreamer fills the dream world with his subconscious, or we are the projections of his subconscious. We live as long as the dreamer is dreaming. In the movie, when Ariadne gets her first lesson on shared dreaming, Kab says that our mind functions more quickly, thereby time feels slow. Hindu religion highlights perfect example of it. In Hindu Vedic texts, it is said that once during the war between Devas and Asuras, Lord Indra took the help of a human king named Muchikunda. The war is believed to have lasted for 1 year in heaven. When Muchikunda told Indra that he wanted to return to earth, Indra tells him that 1 year on heaven is equal to 360 years on earth. In the movie, it is told that as one goes deeper and deeper, time is stretched. Another instance is of a king named Kakudmi and his daughter Revti, who travel to heaven to meet Brahma. Brahma tells them that time runs different on different planes of existence, and that during the short time they had waited to meet him, many years have been passed on earth. It is believed that Lord Vishnu resides in the sixth dimension, and that he uses the fifth dimension to view the timeline of the multiverses. This might sound similar to the tesseract portrayed in the movie Interstellar, again by Christopher Nolan. In the book, The Chronicles of Narnia, Magician's Nephew, when Aslan creates the world of Narnia, it is initially described as a black world, a world where there is just complete darkness, symbolizing limbo. In the movie and the book, The Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe, we see that all the adventures and all the years the Pevensey cousins spent in the world of Narnia is equivalent just to a few seconds in the real world, symbolizing that Narnia could be a higher level dream world. In the movie Inception, it is said that when we die in a dream, we wake up. Similar thing might happen to us living in the dream of God. We may be asleep somewhere, and when we die here, we wake up there. There is also a mention of limbo in the film, which is just a raw infinite subconscious. In Puranas and Vaishnava theology, Maya is described as one of the nine powers of Vishnu. Maya became associated with sleep, and Vishnu's Maya is sleep which envelopes the world when he awakes to destroy evil. Vishnu, like Indra, is the master of Maya, and Maya envelopes Vishnu's body. The Bhagavata Purana narrates that the sage Markandeya requests Vishnu to experience his Maya. Vishnu appears as an infant floating on a fig leaf in a deluge, and then swallows the sage, the sole survivor of the cosmic flood. The sage sees various worlds of the universe, gods, etc., and his own hermitage in the infant's belly. Then the infant breathes out the sage, who tries to embrace the infant, but everything disappears, and the sage realizes that he was in his hermitage the whole time and was given a flavor of Vishnu's Maya.